New at 6, scientists are getting some backlash in their fight to stop the Zika virus. Researchers want to test genetically modified mosquitoes in Florida.
But some people say, not in my backyard. Diane Lee talked to a renowned Clemson entomologist about whether the benefits outweigh the risks.
If there were one thing that could detract from the joys of the warmer months, it's the mosquito. And this year, with the threat of the Zika virus, families like the Fraziers in Greenville are taking action.
Now, learning that potentially the Zika virus could affect adults or children, not just fetuses, that was enough concern for us to make it more of a priority to spray.
Now there's a new technique, the genetically modified mosquito, but it's not without controversy. This Change.org petition aims to stop field testing in Florida, and it has more than 166,000 signatures. So we asked Dr. Peter Adler, a Clemson entomologist, to weigh in.
Now, I think the risks are minimal, and the benefit so far outweighs any risks that we would be remiss if we didn't go forward.
Genetically modified mosquitoes have already been field tested in places like Brazil and the Cayman Islands with a 90% success rate. But it's not a quick fix. This would be an ongoing control strategy. Adler points out the program targets only the species of mosquito most effective at spreading disease, the Aedes aegypti.
Is this going to cause some super mosquito? No, it's not. I mean, it's going to go, these released males are going to go out there, mate with females very quickly, die, and they're returned to the natural environment with no impact.
The biggest impact you can have, he says, is to drain all standing water. That takes the bite out of breeding near your home. And since mosquitoes can't travel but a few hundred yards, it's highly effective. In Clemson, Diane Lee, 7 News.
The Food and Drug Administration has part of the testing, and it has determined that the possibility that these genetically modified mosquitoes could be toxic to people, spread disease, or have adverse impacts on the environment is low or even negligible.